Hi everyone, my name is Aman Singh Tomar. In the previous video, we have integrated the React application with the Firebase. The link is given in the description and on the I button. Today in this video, we will add the authentication in our React application. So for that, I have already created sign up page, sign in page and the dashboard. So this is our sign up page, sign in page. And if we open the localhost 3000, then a dashboard will be open. I have used the material UI template. The link is given in the description. You can check the template. For your reference, I have pushed the code into one repository. So if you are stuck somewhere, then you can visit this repository and check the code. The link will be given in the description. So let's go to the Firebase. Let's go to the authentication. So this is our authentication page when you open first time. So click on get started. These are our authentication providers that Firebase provides. So for now, we are using email password authentication. So let's click on email password authentication, enable it and save it. So email password has been enabled for our application. In the user section, you can check the users. So let's go to the React application. So previously we have created this file and integrated our React application with the Firebase. So now let's do the authentication. So let's import something from Firebase Auth. We have to import the authentication object from the Firebase library. So we will create a variable named as auth and call the getAuth method. We have to give our app reference here with these values. So we will pass the app and we will use the authentication method in our project wherever needed. So let's export it. I have used the named export because in the future we will export other methods also from this file. So now let's go to the signup.js. I have already created the field for name, email and password. And this user info method have all the details of the user like username, email and password that we enter. When user click on the sign up button, this handle submit method will hit. So let's import a method from Firebase that helps us to create a user in Firebase. So let's import something from Firebase Auth. So we will call the create user with email and password method. This method takes three parameters. One is auth object, email and the password. So let's import our auth object that we have exported from the Firebase file. Import auth from Firebase. Let's pass the auth object, our email. Email is an user info object and our password. So by hitting this method with these three parameters, our user will be created in the Firebase console. And this method returns us a promise. So let's handle that promise. Let's put a dot then. And we will create a parameter that is user information. Let's console this user information. We will also catch the error if any came. So Firebase provides us an error object that creates two values. One is error code and second is error message. So let's type it, error code, error message. Let's check this out on the UI. Let's open the console. One more thing I want to tell you, that you can sign up with a fake email in the Firebase. By default, Firebase won't do any email verification. You have to manually add it in your code. So let's put a name. I will add Aman. Put a fake email. And Firebase expects that user needs to enter a 6-digit password. But if you enter less than 6-digit password, then it will throw us an error. So let's enter 4-digit password. In that case, it will throw an error. And see, error is there. So this is the error code and this is the error message. So that password should be at least 6 characters. So by using the error code, you can throw your customized message. So for every error, there will be an error code. Now create our first user. I am putting proper password with 6 characters. Let's hit the sign up button. We got the user object. That means user has been created in the Firebase. So let's check it. Let's refresh it. So our first user has been created. Let's check the user object. The operation is sign in. So it provides us some information like display name. So display name is null because we haven't added the display name in the Firebase. We only passed email and password. It has other values also like email address, phone URL, photo URL, and main the unique ID. So this unique ID is very useful. There is one more provider data. In provider data provides user info. And when you verified the email, this email verified will be true. So let's add the display name. So you can't add the display name or phone number or photo with this method. You have to update the profile. So Firebase provides update profile method to update the profile of the user. So let's call it. And we have two paths, auth.currentUser. So this auth.currentUser provides the current user information. And the second parameter, it's take an object. And in the object, we can pass the display name. So that is user info dot username. You can add the other parameters also like phone number, photo, etc. So I just want to showcase you something. This method also returns us a promise. Okay, so let's not pass the current user so that this method will throw an error. Let's check it. Let's use the another fake address. So I can provide the code with AS and email address with the same code with AS. So this email address is correct. So let's click on sign up. It throws an error in this function because we haven't passed the current user object. That means we haven't passed the current user information. So we should not handle the exceptions of this method because we should not hamper the user experience. So suppose if the user display name is not updated, then you can give the option in the dashboard also. Same for other informations. It's better not to handle it here. So let's pass the proper information. So let's click on the sign up button. So a user has been created. Let's open the user object. So as you can see, now the display name is coming. So if you want any of this property, you can add in that particular object. So now we have to add the email verification functionality. So let's add that method. So we have a built-in method for that. Send email verification. And this will need the auth.currentUser. This method also returns us a promise, but if user verification fails, then we can handle in the dashboard. Let's check in the code. So let's delete this user. We have already created one user with this email. So let's go to the Firebase and delete this user. So by clicking on this three dot, there will be a delete option. You can also reset the password of the user, and for temporarily, if you want to block someone, then you can also disable the account. So let's delete this account. So let's open the Gmail. Let's click on the sign up button. And the user has been created. Let's check the Gmail. Let's click on the link to verify the email address. So now our email has been verified. If you don't want this email address and you want to modify the template of the Gmail, then you can modify it from the Firebase console. Let's go to the Firebase. And in the templates, if you check the email address verification, you can edit this. You can provide your app name or company name, whatever you want. If you have a customized domain, then you can click on it. And rest, if you want, you can customize the action URL also. Let's cancel it. So till now, we haven't routed the user to the dashboard after sign up. So let's do that. So after completing the update profile and the send email verification, we will route it to the dashboard. Let's check it. So we will use a fake address. So for that, we will use one here and one here. We are not using the sign in functionality. We will cover the sign in functionality in the next video. Currently, during this, after signing up, I just want my user to the dashboard. So let's click on the sign up. So after completing the successful sign up, my dashboard is there. So I have provided one logout button, but it is not working right now. So we have to add functionality also for the logout. But there is a catch. If you are opening the localhost 3000, but if you want user to be redirected on the login page, then how you can do that? So for that, we don't have to manage any sessions. Firebase provides us listeners. So with the help of those listeners, we can do that. So let's go to the dashboard page. So let's import something from Firebase Auth. So Firebase provides onAuth state change listener. So if the user is sign in or sign out, this particular listener will get hit and it will take the auth.currentUser, and the second parameter is the callback. In the callback, we will get the user. So if the user value is true, then we are signed in, and if it is false, then we are signed out. So let's print console.log sign in. So if the user is sign out, then we can route it to the login page. I forgot that we don't have to pass the current user objects. We only need to pass the auth. So let's check in the UI. So let's refresh this page. So as you can see, the sign in console has been printed. That means the user is signed in. So let's write the logout functionality. So for logging out, Firebase provides sign out method. So let's write it, sign out. It will take the auth object and provides as a promise, and we can use it. Let's provide the dot catch also. So similarly, this error also provides error.code and error.message. So let's write it. and if we are signed out, then we can route it to the login page. Let's check in the UI, click on the logout button, and we are redirected to the login page. And now if we are trying to open the localhost 3000, then it should redirect us to the login page. And yes, it is correctly redirecting it to the login page. So right now our signup functionality has been completed, and in the next video we will cover the sign-in functionality. We will also add the other authentications like Google authentication and the phone authentication in the upcoming videos. So if you have any question regarding the signup process, then you can write down in the comment section. I will collect all of the questions from the comment section and make it a separate video. So thank you for watching this video.